Hello everyone, today we are going to study about cable stayed bridge. So a cable stayed bridge is basically a bridge which consists of this is a deck and here our support is fixed, likewise here support is also fixed. So it contains of a tower, likewise here we also have a tower and these are cables which are attached to it in order to make it stable like this. This is foundation we have over here. Likewise, cables are also here. So, the basic components of cable stayed bridge are three. Like this deck. It consists of all the traffic. It carry all the traffic loads. And another one is this cable. This is cable. And another one is tower. So basically, three components are there. This is tower. This is cable. And this is deck. So today we are going to study about cable stayed bridges. We are going to design one. We are going to calculate the basically what these cables, what tension, how much tension they are getting. So we are going to calculate that. So for example, we are taking one problem in which we have some. We are going to calculate. We are going to design the cable. Cable stayed bridge. Okay, so some quantities we have given, like span length. Span length we have given as 160 meters, and width of deck. Given as 10 meters, and some other quantities are also given. Width of roadway, whose quantity is 7.5 meters. This is the measurement of two legs. And the number of cables, total number of cables are 34. And the spacing of cables, like the spacing between each cable is 6 meters. And the thickness of RCC deck slab, we have a deck slab, whose thickness is equals to 1 ATM, and our bearing board thickness is 70 mm, and the longitudinal girder equals to 600 mm. 800 mm, and we have a loading of class plus AA, right? So from all this data, we have these values. Like this is our tower. And this is our deck. So the total number of cables on the one side are from here 1 starting, and they were total here up to 34. Like 17 are on this side and another 17 are on this side. Okay. And now from all this data we can conclude, like this is a deck slab. So this is our deck slab whose thickness is 180 mm, and this is given in question. It's 180 mm. This is the cross girder, and this is the longitudinal girder. This is cross girder. So whose dimensions were here given as? This dimension is 600 mm,
and this dimension is a. Just given as the question. These all are given as questions. And from here, we have tables. This table and this table on both the dimensions, on both the sides. And this total span, as it is given by the question, that width of that is 10 meter. So this is 10 meter from here to here. Then, another thing, that these cross girders are at the interval of 3 meter. Of 3 meter. Like 3 meter, 3 meter, 3 meter, like this one. So, now we are going to calculate the live load. In this live load calculation, this is the first lab. So how we are going to calculate the live loads is like this is our deck and this is our vehicle. Vehicle wheel. So according to class A drag vehicle, loading each wheel is 350 kN. So the center of gravity of this load, we are calculating that it is pointing at center of this. This distance is 2 meter. So, this total distance is 10 meter, which is given in the span like this. And the value is the distance between the this vehicle to this. This is 1.2 meter. So the distance from here to here, we got as 7.4 meter. So now, if we are finding the reactions, so we have two reactions, like reactions we have found up, which is given as 700. This total load 700 into this distance by total. After calculating this, we are getting the value of 518 kilometers. So, after that, this is the calculated reaction. We have calculated the reaction. Now we are calculating dead load. Now we are calculating the dead load. For dead load, weight of deck slab. Weight of deck slab is calculated by using 0.25. 0.25 came from 180 mm plus 70 mm into the unit weight, which is equal to 24. So after calculating this, we got the value of 6 kN. Per meter square. So we got the weight of deck slab. Now weight of longitudinal girder. It is what are the dimensions of longitudinal girder is? It is 600 mm wide and 800 mm high. So it is 0.6 into 0.8 into 24. So from here we get the value as 11.5 kN per meter. So now moving onward, we are calculating the weight of cross girder. For calculating this, we have the dimension of cross girder is 0.45 into 0.8 is the height. Okay, exactly. 0.8 into 24. So after calculating this, we are getting the value as 8.5 kN. So the total weight, so we are now taking the span of about 6 meter by 10 meter. We are going to do analysis on that part only, whatever be the cables that are coming in that portion. So weight of deck slab is equals to, for that 6 meter part, it is 6 into 10 into 6. This 6 is this area, this dead load. So after calculating this, we are getting the value of 360 kN. moving forward, same weight of longitudinal girder. If you are calculating it, you are getting the value of 2 into 11.5 into this 11.5 is this, and 6 is the distance that for which you are calculating it, and two longitudinal girders are here. That's why we are calculating for 2. After calculating it, we are getting the value of 138 kN. Likewise, for cross girder, we are also going to calculate. So total number of cross girders for the spacing is 3 into 10 into 8.5. This 8.5 came from here. So after calculations, we will get it as 255 kN. Now, the total load will be equals to 750 kN. So total reactions, now fourth step, total reaction. Total reaction will be equals to, due to light load, it is equals to 5.8 kN. Due to dead load, it is equals to 375 kN. And for footpath and other like handrail, we are adding it. So after this, digging into it, parapet railing. And other dead loads and any other loads, we are getting the value as 167 kN. Now the total reaction after calculating all this equals to 1000. So we get this value at the end. Now for designing the cable. Now final step is to design the cable. So we have a formula for this. This formula is P equals to R upon sine alpha. Where these values are given by, like this we have a diagram. We are assuming that our load is acting at this 6 meter. At the center of this load, this angle will be alpha. So from here we will calculate the value of alpha. The height of this is 34 meter to here. And the total length of this will be 40 meter and 40 meter, because the length of total deck bridge is, 160, so 80 on this side and 80 on this side. The reaction will be occur at this point. So moving onwards, after calculating the alpha here, we get the value of this R, we have value as 1000, and sin alpha after calculating we get at 0.65. So the force in the cable is given by 1538 kN. Now This cable consists of a 37 number of high tension cables, high tension wires, 37 high tension wires whose dia is 7 mm in each cable. So force in each wire given by the area of each 10 wire into the initial pre-stress in 10 ton is equals to 1200 newton per mm square. So this into 1200 divided by 1000. So in each wire they are getting this force which is equal to 46 kN. So the number of wires will be given as the total force we are getting is 1538 divided by, we get the value of number of wires as 35. So we have to provide 35 buyers on each side. In a single tower, we have to provide 35 approximately wires. So that's it. Thank you.